नमस्ते गुरुकुलियंस, होप यू ऑल आर सेलिंग इन द बोट ऑफ जॉय एंड आर सेफ एट योर होम्स। सो बेटा, इन दिस वेरी लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द चैप्टर सेकेंड ऑफ योर क्लास। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स। ओके, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट आर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक योर बैक्टीरिया, प्रोटोजोवा एज वेल एज फंगी। Now in this lecture we are going to discuss about two more microorganism, that is algae, first one, and the second one is your what beta? Virus. In the previous lecture I asked one question about your COVID-19. That means this disease is caused by which kind of microorganisms? Okay. After discussing these two microorganisms, I am going to answer that question. Okay. So let's get started with the first thing, that is your algae. Algae is a microorganism, and the second thing is beta, algae can be of unicellular as well as multicellular. That means it can be unicellular, made up of only one kind of cell, or it can be what? Multicellular. Okay, so there are certain algae which are unicellular, and we are also having the algae which are multicellular. Yani ki bacche more than one cell, made up of more than one cell. The second thing, where are they found? Algae, they are found mainly in water bodies. Okay, like your rivers, okay, the lakes you can say, and the reservoir. Okay, third thing, they are unicellular, their type of existence, where they are existing. The next thing about algae is beta, some kind of algae, they contain chlorophyll in it. If they contain chlorophyll, like plants contain chlorophyll, so they are able to prepare their own food. Same in the case with algae, they are having chlorophyll, so they can prepare their own food. Okay, they are not dependent on any other thing for their survival. Okay, some kinds of algae, they having chlorophyll and they are able to prepare their own food. So some of the examples, okay, some of the example of your algae is Volvox, Spirozyra, okay, Volvox, Spirozyra, as well as Chlamydomonas. Okay, so Chlamydomonas. Okay, the pronunciation should be correct. So it's Chlamydomonas, Volvox, Spirozyra, and Chlamydomonas. Now about their length, are these algae very minute or they are several meter long? Beta, they are both minute, that means very very small, to several meter long. Okay, so this is all about your algae. Okay, now again I'm going to tell you, algae, they are both unicellular and multicellular. They exist mainly in water bodies. Okay, they contain chlorophyll, so are able to prepare their own food. Example of algae, Volvox, Spirozyra, Chlamydomonas. The next is, they are minute as well as several meter long. Okay, now the next is our virus part. Virus, they are very very small in size, very small. Okay, very small in size, very good. Second thing, they can be seen only with the help of electron microscope. बेटा द रेस्ट ऑफ द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म दे आर विजिबल विद योर माइक्रोस्कोप. ओके सो वी कैन ईजिली सी दैम विद द हेल्प ऑफ सिंपल माइक्रोस्कोप. बट दीज वायरसेस दे आर इवन स्मॉलर देन ऑल द वट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो वी नीड अ स्पेशल इंस्ट्रूमेंट. दिस इज इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप इज वेरी पावरफुल एंड ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट वी आर एबल टू सी वट वायरसेस. ओके स्टूडेंट्स सो नाउ नेक्स्ट थिंग दे आर वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज. ओके एंड दे आर वी आर एबल टू सी देम ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. The star point about these viruses are, these viruses are active. That means they are active when they are inside the living cell. They can only be active when they are present inside the living cell. That means this COVID-19, okay, I'm going to answer the question. This COVID-19 is just because of your virus. Coronavirus. The virus of this disease belongs to corona family. Okay. So this COVID-19 is spreading just because of what? Microorganism virus. Okay. And these viruses, when the corona virus, they are going to enter inside the body through respiration process, through the breathing. Okay. When it enter inside your body, it attack your living cells. Only then it become active. If it is present in the air, it is in its inactive form. So these viruses, they are active when present inside what? Living cells. They are active and they reproduce themselves. That means they multiplied in number only when they entered inside the living cell. This is a very specific thing. Okay. Viruses causes many disease. Okay, they cause many disease like HIV. HIV is a virus that causes AIDS. Okay, example of viruses we can say your poliovirus. The poliovirus causes polio disease. HIV causes AIDS. The next example of virus is bacteriophage. Bacteriophage. Okay. So what you have to remember, its properties related to your virus and your example. So these are the two things and the answer to this question is it is spreading just because of virus. Okay. So now next thing we are going to discuss is, okay, just tell me one thing, beta. Do all the microorganisms, they are harmful to us? Or some of them are useful to us? Beta, microorganisms are useful to us also. Okay? Some of the microorganisms, they are used in your food industries for the preparation of food. Okay? Like your bread, cheese, pickles, wine, vinegar, etc. Okay, and some of the microorganisms they are used in medical purposes. Medical purposes for the preparation of your antibiotics as well as vaccines. So now the scientists are struggling for the preparation of COVID-19 vaccine. Are you getting my point? Because mainly the viral diseases, the diseases that are spreading by the virus, they are cured with the help of vaccines. Okay, and it will take long time to prepare a vaccine as compared to any antibiotic. Okay, we are going to discuss it in this very lecture. So now, starting thing is useful microorganism. Usefulness, you can say that, of your microorganisms. Okay, so they are used in your food industries first for the preparation of food. They are also used for medical purposes and third, they are used to increase the fertility of your soil. Increase the fertility of soil. So in today's lecture we are going to start with the first thing in food industries. In food industries, how they are useful in food industries. Okay, here I am going to take the example of your two microorganisms. Okay, one is your lactobacillus, okay, bacteria, and the another one is your yeast. So in food industries, I am going to take two examples. Okay, lactobacillus and your yeast. Lactobacillus yeast. Okay, so now starting with the lactobacillus. Lactobacillus is a kind of bacteria. Okay, and in the starting of lecture number 1, I discussed the formation of curd. So the particular microorganism that is responsible for curd formation is your lactobacillus, is the lactobacillus. So now in the warm milk, okay, in the slightly warm milk, the mother is going to what? The mother is going to add a very small amount of curd, and that particular curd contain this microorganism that is your lactobacillus. So now when this microorganism enter inside the milk, what will going to happen? The function of this microorganism lactobacillus is to convert sugar present in the milk to your acid, and specifically lactic acid, okay, in curd. Getting my point? So the only thing this microorganism will do is conversion of sugar present in the milk to your acids. Okay, some of the student might think that there is no sugar in the milk because we are not added any sugar. Okay, but beta, naturally in milk sugar is present. Okay, so this microorganism converts their sugar to this lactic acid, and just because of this acid the curd is sour in taste. Okay, so this microorganism not only used for the preparation of your curd but also for the formation of yogurt, pickle, wine, vinegar. Okay, so in all the things, cheese, you can also say that cheese. Okay, so it is used for the preparation of all these things, and only function, the star thing is its function. It converts sugar to acid, that is lactic acid. The next is your yeast. Yeast is a fungus. Okay, it is present in the form of dry powder, and the main function of this yeast is to convert the sugar present in that dough. Dough means beta, like in the morning your mother is converting that flour into dough. Okay, आटा गूंदते हैं ना, तो जो आटा गूंदने के बाद हमारे पास जो बन जाता है आटा गूंधा हुआ, उसे क्या बोलते हैं? डो. सो जो शुगर बेटा उस डो में प्रेजेंट है, व्हाट दे विल डू, इट विल कन्वर्ट, द यीस्ट विल कन्वर्ट दिस शुगर टू कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, एंड दिस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज गोइंग टू रिलीज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बबल्स. ओके, सो the bread is spongy or soft, and in the formation of cake the base is also very soft and spongy. Why? What is the reason for this? The sponginess is caused just because of this microorganism that is your yeast, because it helps in the release of your carbon dioxide in the form of bubbles, and from that dough when these bubbles came out it will become spongy. Okay, the more the production of carbon dioxide, the more fluffiness in the bread or in the cake. Okay, are you getting my point? So this is your function of the yeast. So now the next is about the process, that is your fermentation. Okay, so what is a fermentation process? Fermentation is conversion of, okay, just focus on the board, conversion of sugar present in a substance to your alcohol and carbon dioxide. So this is the process that is known as fermentation. And your wines, the vinegar, okay, the pickles, they all are produced or are made up of by this process, that is your fermentation. Getting my point? So the next thing is regarding your medical purposes, okay? Firstly, in the food industries. Now the next one is in the medicine purposes. So these microorganisms, they are used for the production of medicines or for the production of your two things, that is medicinal purpose firstly in the preparation of antibiotics and second vaccines. So now we are going to discuss this two things, okay? Now firstly, what is the difference between this antibiotic as well as the vaccine? This is the very first question that should come in your mind, being a science student. Ma'am, what is the difference? So now listen to me very carefully. Antibiotics are produced with the help of microorganisms and they are used to kill or prevent the growth of your disease causing microbes. Okay, disease causing microbes. So now these antibiotics, they are produced from microorganism. For example, penicillium is a microorganism and is used to prepare penicillin, which is a antibiotic. Okay, the second thing is streptomyces is an organism, microorganism, and is used for the production of antibiotic, that is your streptomycin. So they are produced with the help of what? Microorganism. Okay, they are produced with the help of microorganism. There are certain kinds of microorganism that produces antibiotics and these are used to prevent and kill the disease causing microorganism that are present inside your body. Are you getting my point? So the example of antibiotic, the first is your penicillium. Okay, penicillium is a fungus and used to produce what? Penicillin. Okay, and similarly the streptomyces, okay, it is a bacteria and used to produce what? Streptomyces. Okay, streptomyces used to produce streptomycin. And another is chloramphenicol. Okay, so this is about antibiotics. The next is vaccine. So what are vaccines and why we need vaccinations? Like a newborn baby, okay, it require vaccinations from various diseases. The doctor is going to give him vaccination through injections, okay? They can be taken either orally or through injections, okay, in both the cases. And these vaccines, what are they? They are made up of dead or weak disease causing microbes. That means the microorganism that causes disease, we are going to do what? We are going to just weaken the strength of that microorganisms, or either the dead microorganism we are going to what? Inject inside the human body. And what the human body is going to do? In the reaction, okay, of this injection of the vaccine, our body is going to produce what? Antibodies. Our body is going to produce what? Antibodies. These antibodies are the warriors. Okay, they are going to act. They attack this disease causing microbes. Okay, they are going to attack these disease causing microbes and they kill them. And they also help in the removal of these disease causing microbes from the body. So what is the thing? When the vaccine is done, okay, in the pets also we did vaccination, and in the vaccinations we are going to insert the disease causing microbes, but in their weak form or in their dead form. And then in the response our body is going to produce what? Antibodies. And these antibodies acting as an army inside the body, and they just kill those disease causing microbes. Okay, and they help in their removal. Now they are also stored in the body. Antibodies, they are also stored inside the body for any future attack. Okay, and the example of these: polio, okay, tuberculosis, tetanus. Okay, these are the diseases which can be prevented with the help of your vaccines. And the process of injecting or by oral taking, this is known as vaccination process. So I hope this lecture is clear to you, that what is the difference between a antibiotic and vaccine. Antibiotics, they are produced with the help of microorganism, but these vaccines, what they are going to do, they are going to stimulate the human body to produce antibodies. Similarly, in the case of COVID-19, okay, we are going to produce a vaccine. That means we are going to produce the dead or the weakest form, and so that our body is going to produce the antibodies. The research is still going on. Okay, so in the next lecture we'll discuss further the same chapter. So okay beta, thank you, all the best.